This is a production of PBS 39.
There are a lot of opinions as to what's healthy and what's not. Our next story introduces you to a woman who says simple changes in your environment can have a big impact on your health. Nicole Brewer has more on how building biology and feng shui techniques could be the answer to healthy and harmonious homes.
For more than a decade, Denise Gallant has called this Allentown residence home.
My husband and I bought this house 14 years ago, and it really was a fixer-upper.
In that time, she's renovated, decorated, and maintained her property, but recently decided to take things one step further by answering the question some fail to ask, how healthy is my home?
I've got a curious mind, and I'm always interested in finding out why something might be happening or not happening.
Enter Carol Cannon. As a certified building biologist, she works with clients like Denise in an attempt to make their homes more healthy and harmonious.
It's a way of looking at the building and the built environment that people are living and working in and seeing how the building is affecting human health.
That's done through a one-on-one consultation at the client's home or office.
In building biology, we look at to nature as our guide. So as close as we can get to the way you would feel in nature, that's our goal.
Carol begins the session by testing for high levels of electromagnetic fields, or EMFs, something she says can cause sleep apnea or other health problems. So what should the meter say?
1 to 2 is moderate, 2 to 5 is more dangerous, and then anything over 5 is extremely dangerous.
Common household appliances like refrigerators, microwaves, and dishwashers often emit high EMF levels.
You can see how it jumped up to 69. I mean, that's very, very high.
And while Carol says it's okay to have them in your home, she says it's best not to have them in areas where you spend a lot of time.
6, 17, 19, as we get closer to the back, 20. This is an example of why you wouldn't want this on the other side of your bed.
Televisions and alarm clocks also emit high EMF levels, but if you can't live without your bedside gadgets, Carol recommends using batteries, moving the device across the room, or simply unplugging it when it's not in use. Small changes, Denise says, she can handle.
I'm really amenable to looking at rearranging, doing things to just make the room more healthy.
And that includes good water and air quality. Carol recommends using a distiller or filter for purification and recommends using organic cleaning products when possible.
Carol says having real plants in a room is helpful because they help to absorb odors or harmful chemicals that may be present. She also suggests opening a window, an instant way to prove air quality in your home
or your office. Carol recently worked with Dennis and Lee Hornick, co-owners of the organic mattress store in Hellertown. They say her services improve their health and their bottom line.
As a result, people are buying more, we think, because we do have this kind of a building, this kind of a showroom.
They feel very relaxed here and they comment on it.
And while no major research exists to prove the effectiveness of Carol's line of work, major corporations have jumped on the bandwagon. Companies like Coca-Cola, Hewlett-Packard, and Procter & Gamble all employ feng shui principles, which also use nature as a guide.
Feng shui is an ancient art of placement. It was started over 5,000 years ago in China, and it's all about balancing your environment to improve your own personal qi.
So what exactly does that mean? I decided to find out.
Basically, when I came to this apartment, it was already set up.
With some basic information, Carol tailored my consultation to balance what she called my inner qi.
We like to look at where this person originated from, where were they born, when were they born.
The first thing she noticed about my apartment, so-called barriers created by furniture placement.
Saying, don't come in, I don't really want to have friends.
Exactly. Carol developed a vision for the room.
The L shape and move it here and then put the bookcase on the opposite side of the wall and center the television. I think you'll have a much more pleasing situation here.
And after a little rearranging, transformed my living room into a full-fledged feng shui fortress. Okay, that might be a slight exaggeration, but Carol says we made vast improvements.
It also opens up the space for new things to come into your life.
My bedroom, on the other hand, passed with flying colors.
your bedroom is actually set up very nicely.
Really?
Yes.
The only things that had to go were a few extra books, candles, and my clothing rack. Items Carol says created clutter.
Cleaning up the clutter is a big issue. It's one of the easiest things, I think, to start with.
Only time will tell if my new setup has any effect on my life. In the meantime, I'm still trying to find my inner chi. For Tempo, I'm Nicole Brewer reporting.